Okay, welcome back. So the next part is find the slope of the line and explain what the slope means in this context. So we've lots of different ways of finding the slope of the line. The first thing that we could do is we could use our rise over run, just like in coordinate geometry. So we can just pick two points along the line and then see what the rise is and what is the run and put the rise over the run, and that's our slope. So in this case, if we take this point and we take this point, because those are the two we plotted, what's the run from here across to here? In other words, what's the distance from here to here? It's a distance of 5, isn't it? And what's the rise going from here to there? In other words, how far up have you gone? From 10 up to 20, it's a rise of 10, isn't it? So if it's rise over run, which is 10 over 5, our slope is 10 divided by 5, 2. Okay, so that was one way of doing it. We could have taken these two points and used a coordinate geometry formula for finding slope. You know, use the zero, you treat this as your x and that as your y-axis, and call this 0, 10, and call this 5, 20, and then use the formula from your log tables to find slope. That would be another way. Another way, though, I suppose, and this is something that's unique to patterns or something new that we need to know, is that whatever the common difference is, or the constant first difference in a linear pattern is, that will always be the slope when we go and draw a graph.